Good morning, dear students. I, Vidyasagar, your SS teacher. Welcome you all in the e-learning class of Modern International School. So, I am going to start subject SPL of Standard 6. And this is second video lecture on the topic, What is Government? From Chapter 3. Dear students, we have already discussed that there are three levels of government. National level, state level and district level, or you can say the local government. So each and every government, they having their own responsibility. It means the national level government, they have the responsibility that from the entire the country, any of the issues are there, then they have to solve it. Where the state level government, they have the responsibility that within the entire state, if there any issues is there or any development program or any health issue are there, then they have to sort out it. Further, we'll see the district level government, or you can say the local government, including the block, the village panchayat, including your village also. These all responsibilities are under the district level government. So in basically the three level government have been divided, and this was done by a committee which was known as Balwant Rai Mehta Samiti. Now you will come to know that if the matter is about the India, then the national level government will handle it. If the matter is about the Bihar, then state level government is handle it. And if the matter is about Nawada, then the district level government will attend it. Okay, that's why it is given that three tier government is provided here. Next topic is about the law and the government. The government that itself, they run under a law, and the government also make the law for the public. It means all above the law. The law is all above the government also and the public also. So the government issue the certain law for a particular work, and that they used to provide it. Like the government, they has the power to make the decisions and also has the power to enforce it decisions. Like for example, you can take that any of the person who is driving, riding a motorcycle, then he should have the license that he can ride the bike. It means any person, if he is caught without a driving license, then he will be charged or he can be put behind the jail or he could be fined. So these, without these law, the government power to make decision is not much of use. Like in addition, the government can take, there are also steps that people, if they feel that particular law is not being followed, like if the peoples, because as we know in the democracy, it is important, the public criteria, it is most important, because if the public thinks that any of the particular thing is not happening clearly, then it should be prevented. And if the public, it is thinking that these things are going on smoothly, then it's fine. If it is not doing, then the public ever used to do the dharna rallies against the existing government. These are the basic rights which have been given by the constitution for the public, because the government is for the publics, and the representatives which are being elected by the publics, their duty that they have to work for the publics. And further, the types of government. Dear students, basically there are the two types of government which are mentioned here. Like in a democratic government, another is about the monarchy. So the democratic form of government is about that the democratic form of government which is responsible toward the public, or you can say it another word, that those government which are being elected by the peoples, and it is also for the peoples and by the peoples. It means democracy is the form of government in which the government is being elected by the peoples and it is for the public. Or you can say that in the democracy the public they used to choose it, and further these government perform their own works according to the need of the public. These are the basic rules which are being founded in the democracy. Another is about the monarchy. So monarchy, which was in the earlier times, which was basically mainly treated in the earlier times, and nowadays very few countries were there. Nowadays at those countries also the democracy is also existing day by day. So the monarchy form of government, in that form of government the queen or the king, they are just the descendant of their ancestors, and they are taking the position of the king or queen according to their ancestors, wherever they are not responsible toward the publics. If any public is asking, then if they want to do the answer, then they will give. If they don't want to give, then they will not give it. But wherever, if we look about in the democratic government, then if the public they have raised a question, then the government, they are approved, they are authorized to give the correct answer, whatever the public want to take from the government. So these are the major differences which are being seen. As we will see, we'll go through the history, then we'll found that at the earlier times basically the monarchy form of government was existing in the earlier times, but nowadays that the democracy, it is existing, and the peoples also understood the form of the democracy and they are living in it. Okay, students, read the paragraph and keep watching. Thank you.